Good morning students, today I am going to start with exercise 4.2 simple equations. Okay, till now you have learned how to make an equation, but now in this exercise you are going to learn how to get the value of x, how to get the value of how to solve an equation. Okay, so let's take one example. This is question number one, part A of an exercise 4.2, and the question is solve the equation. Give first the step you will use to separate the variables and then solve the equation. So basically you need to solve the equation, and the equation is x minus 1 is equals to 0. Let's take another example simultaneously, and the next example is x plus 1 is equals to 0. So you have an equation x minus 1 is equals to 0. So first x is equals to 1, the step is transpose 1 to RHS. So basically you have moved 1 from LHS to RHS, so obviously this sign got interchanged, right? So earlier you have negative sign here, but now you have positive sign, the sign got changed, right? So when you transpose any value, any digit from one side to another side, sign got changed. Uska sign change ho jayega beta agar aap koi bhi value, koi bhi digit ko agar aap LHS to RHS ya RHS to LHS transpose karte hain, so obviously sign gets changed. Uska jo sign hoga wo change ho jayega. Okay, so the value of x is equals to 1. So this is your answer and this is the step. Now the first step is transpose 1 to the RHS, Now this one, this is positive here in the LHS, but when you take it in the RHS, the sign gets changed, right? So x is equals to minus 1. So sign gets changed. So whenever you move a digit from LHS to RHS or from RHS to LHS, sign gets changed. Okay, its sign gets changed. Here it was negative, so it become positive. Here it was positive, so it become negative. So this is the solution. This is your answer. Note it down fast. Or I can take one more example here. I think this is part C. X minus 1 is equals to 5. Now here you have 5 in the RHS, earlier you have 0 in the RHS, right? So first you take this 1 to the RHS. So x is equals to 5. Now when you move this 1, from LHS to RHS, sign gets changed. Here it is negative, so it become positive. So x is equals to 5 plus 1, 6. So this is your answer. Note it down, this thing. Okay, some question I am leaving intentionally for you as a homework, but if you find any difficulty while solving those questions, you people are free to ask me in the Google Meet class, okay? Don't worry. Now, I will take one more example. G. Part G and part H, okay? Y plus 4 is equals to 4 and part H is Y plus 4 is equals to minus 4. Okay, now why? In the very first step, take this 4 from LHS to RHS. So when you take this 4 from LHS to RHS, sign gets negative, sign becomes changed. That is, here it is positive, so it becomes negative. Negative of 4. So 4 minus 4 is 0. So this is the solution, this is the answer. Now here it is minus 4 in the RHS. So when you take this 4 from LHS to RHS, its sign got changed from positive to negative and it become minus 4. Earlier in the LHS it was plus 4, but now after transposition it become minus 4. Now minus 4 minus 4, right? Minus 4 minus 4 is minus 8. So when you have same sign, that means addition will take place and negative sign will be there. Whenever you have two negative values, so it gets add up to 4, so like this 4 plus 4 8 and the sign is negative. Okay, note it down first, then I will take next example, next question, question number 2. Now question number 7, question saying solve the equation. First is part A. Second question part A, 3L is equals to 42. So first you need to cross multiply the values. Now what is cross multiplication is? You need to calculate the value of L. So whatever is the coefficient of L, you need to cross multiply it like this. So this is cross multiplication. Why I am saying cross multiplication? Cross, it is forming a cross sign here, right? This one is multiplied by 42 and this 3 is multiplied by 1. So L is equals to 42 into 1 divided by 1 into 3. Now 3 1s are 3 and 3 4s are 12. So the value of L is equals to 14. So this is your answer. This is how you solve this equation and you solve the value of L. Now part C. P upon 7 is equals to 4 upon 1. Again, you need to cross multiply these values. So P into 1 is equals to 7 into 4. So P into 1, if you multiply 1 with any other number, the answer is number itself, right? So this is P is equals to 7 4s are 28. So the answer is 28. Now, again, you have an equation 7 z upon 3 is equals to 5 upon 4. So first cross multiply these values. So z into 4 is equals to 3 into 5. Now in the third step, this is the second step. In the third step, because you need to calculate the value of z, the value which is multiplied with z, take it in the denominator by cross multiplication. So the value of z comes out to be 5 3s are 15 divided by 4, or you can write, leave it as it is, okay. So this is how you calculate the value of a variable, okay, because L, Z, P, these all are the variables in these questions, okay. Note it down first. The remaining question is for your homework, but if you have any doubt while solving those questions, people are free to ask me, okay, don't worry. But before that, watch these videos, submit your work on time and attend your Google Meet classes, okay, then only people are able to ask your doubts and queries, okay. Okay, now question number third, part A. Again, the question is same, solve the equation, right? Now 3n, first take this 2 to the RHS, so this is 46. When you take this 2 to the RHS, the sign got changed. Here it is minus 2, so it become plus 2. So 3n is equals to 48. Now cross multiply 3, so what you will have, 48 into 1 divided by 3 into 1. So 3 1s are 3, 6 are 18, so the value of n is equals to 16. First you took this minus 2 from LHS to RHS, it become plus 2. Sign get opposite. Now 3n is equals to 46 plus 2 is 48. Now you need to calculate the value of n, so 3 need to be cross multiplied with 1. So take this 3 to the denominator and take this 1 to the numerator. So 48 into 1 is itself 48 and 3 into 1 itself 1. So 3 16s are 48, so n is equals to 16. Now, so this is the answer. Okay. Now part C is B and D is for your homework. Okay. 20 P upon 3 is equals to 40. Now, first cross multiply these values. So P is equals to 3 into 40. And 20 into 1, So 22s are 40, so 3 2s are 6, so P is equals to 6. So this is your answer, okay?
Note it down first.
Now question number 4, part B. 10P plus 10 is equals to 100. 10P as it is, take this 10 to the RHS. Earlier it was plus 10, now it become minus 10. Sign got changed, right? Now 10P is equals to 10 minus 100 minus 10 is 90. Now cross multiply the values. Now you will get 90 divided by 10, and 90 into 1 is again 90, and 10 into 1 is 10, right? So 10 nines are 90. So the value of P is equals to 9. So this is the answer. Okay, now part A is minus P upon 3 is equals to 5 divided by 1. Now minus P can be written as minus 1 into P, right? Beta, minus P can be written as minus 1 into P divided by 3 is equals to 5 divided by 1. Now cross multiply the values. 3 into 5 minus 1 into 1, so what you have, P is equals to 3 into 5 divided by minus 1 into 1. So minus 1 ones are minus 1. 3 5s are 15. So either you can write 15 upon minus 1, or you can simply write minus 15. So the answer is P is equals to minus 15. So this is your answer. Okay, note it down fast. Now the part G is 3s plus 12 is equals to 0. So first take this 12 to the RHS. In the LHS it is plus 12, in RHS it is minus 12. Sign get changed, right? Now cross multiply the values. Make the variable alone. Make the variable alone that you need to calculate in the question, okay? So S is equals to minus 12 into 1 divided by 3 into 1. So 3 4s are 12, so minus 4. So the value of S is equals to minus 4. This is your answer. Okay, now part L. I'm saying this thing that the question that I'm leaving intentionally are for your homework. But still, if you have any doubt in those questions, if you find it difficult to solve, if you find it difficult while solving those questions, you people are free to ask me in the Google Meet class. But before that, please try these questions and watch these videos, okay? 2q plus 6 is equals to 12. First take is 6 to the RHS, okay? 2q is equals to 12 minus 6. 12 minus 6 is 6, okay? So 2q is equals to 6. Now make this variable alone, so cross multiply with 1, 1 with 6. So what you have, q is equals to 6 into 1 divided by 1 into 2, so 2 3s are 6, so the value of q is 3. So this is the solution of this equation. Now okay, I'm taking one question, that is part H. Part H, that is 3s is equals to 0. This is the question. Now okay, 3s is equals to 0, cross multiply 3 and cross multiply 1, so what you will get, s is equals to 0 into 1, 0, 3 ones are 3, and 0 upon any number is 0, so 0 is your answer.
Okay,
if you divide 0 with any other number, the answer is 0. But the answer is changed if you divide a number by 0. The answer is indefinite. Okay? Or you can say infinite. Okay? So this is all about exercise 4.2. Now, okay, still some more time is left. So
I'll start with exercise 4.3 now. Okay.
Now starting with exercise 4.3.
Now students, this is exercise 4.3, question number 1. Though the concept is same, but the level is somewhat higher than the exercise 3.2.
Now you have some values in fractions also. The concept is same. Take this 5 by 2 in the RHS. So 37 by 2, here 5 by 2 is positive, right? So make it negative in RHS 5 by 2. Now take LCM. What is the LCM of 2 and 2? Obviously 2 will be the LCM. 2 1s are 2, 1 37 is 37. 2 1s are 2, so 1 into 5 is 5. Right? 2y as it is. Now 2y divided by 1 is equals to 37 minus 5 gives you 32 divided by 2. Okay? Cross multiply this 2 and make this variable alone. Y is equals to 32 into 1 divided by 32 into 1 and 2 into 2. Now 2 1s are 2, 2 6s are 12 and 2 8s are 16. So the value of y is 8. Same concept that you have used in exercise 4.2 for finding the value of any variable. Okay?
Note it down fast, then I'll take some more examples. But rest is for your homework.
So this was part A.
Now this is part B.
5t plus 28 is equals to 10. Same concept, 5t. Take this plus 28 to the RHS. It becomes minus 28. So 5t is equals to minus 18. The reason is the number which is greater is with negative sign. So that's why negative sign is here, and overall subtraction will be there. 28 minus 10 is minus 18. Okay. Now 5t is equals to minus 18, so take this 5 in the denominator and make this t alone. So t is equals to minus 18 into 1 divided by 5 into 1, so minus 18 divided by 5, this is your answer. So this is the value of t.
Okay, two more parts.
This is f. 5 by 2 x is equals to 25 by 4. The first step is cross multiplication. So what you have, x is equals to 25 into 2 divided by 5 into 4. 5 5s are 24 and 2 2s are 4. So the value of x is 5 divided by 2. This is your answer. You just cross multiply the values, like 25 into 2 and 5 into 4. You have 25 divided by 4, 2 divided by 4. So 2 2s are 4 and 5 5s are 25. So the answer is 5 by 2. Now the next part is part G. 7 is equal to this. So first take this 19 by 2 to the RHS. So 7m as it is, 13 minus 19 divided by 2. Why 19? Because I have transposed this value from LHS to RHS. Now, take LCM 1 into, the LCM of 1 into is 2. 1 2s are 2 and 2 into 13 is 26. 2 1s are 2, 1 into 19 is 19. So, 7m divided by 1 is equals to 26 minus 19 is 7, right? So this can be written as 7 by 2. So 7m divided by 1 is equals to 7 by 2, or I can write is equals to 7 into 1 divided by 7 into 2. So the answer is 1 upon 2. So the value of M is 1 upon 2. This is your answer.
Note it down fast. So this is all for the day, students. Question number 2, question number 3 are based on the same concept. So this is all about exercise 4.2 and 4.3, that how to calculate a value of a variable in a given equation. Okay, so today we have learned some basic concept of transposition. When you take a value from LHS to RHS, or you take a value from RHS to LHS, its sign got changed, right? Similarly, you have learned one more concept, is cross multiplication, how to cross multiply two values for getting the value of unknown variable. Okay, so this is all for the day, students. I just request you again, please watch this video, attend your Zoom session, Google Meet class. Earlier it was Zoom classes, so I was confused, sorry. And submit your work on time. Okay, students. Okay, then, thank you.